I'm Carolina.
I'm Jasper.
I'm Casper Meijer.
Hi guys, Norbert.
My code is only 30 lines big.
It's a pretty big stakes here, no doubt about it. And a chance to compete for the title of Deep Racer League 2019 champion.
Maybe we should tune the hyperparameters. Try only the speed.
It seems amazing to give machines some intelligence.
Yeah. We will fight and see what algorithm is better.
We are down to just the last 2.5 hours.
Time, 42.50.
26.
2091.
Oh, that's still good. That's still good.
Two laps, pretty close. There it is officially.
Let's see what happened at the end of the day.
Welcome to the world's first autonomous racing league. Developers of every skill level from all corners of the globe compete for the ultimate prize in machine learning. Welcome to Deep Racer TV. The Dutch city of Amsterdam is known for its canals, electronic music, and rusty bicycles. But it was also recently named the best tech city in Europe. And there's tons of excitement here as developers are lining up outside the Rai to get ready for the first global autonomous racing league. To register an official time on the leaderboard, the clock starts now.
Our first competitor will be taking to the track here very soon.
You can get two wheels in the green. That's still good, that's still good. It's only if all four wheels are in that disqualifies you.
I'm Blaine Sundred with AWS Training and Certification, and I'm a subject matter expert for AWS Deep Racer.
Get your opportunity on the track with our fantastic Deep Racer cars. These are really cool tech.
AWS Deep Racer is a 1/18th scale, fully autonomous racing vehicle. It's controlled entirely by reinforcement learning.
The car knows how to drive itself?
This is the point of the reinforcement learning, right?
Each developer will have 4 minutes on the track to place their best time. They need to complete one full circuit around the track with less than 3 faults in order for their time to qualify.
The top 10 will get to bring home one of these Deep Racer cars. The top 3 will have some special gear to bring home as well.
The best time today will win the AWS Amsterdam Cup and an expenses paid trip to compete at AWS reInvent against all the other Summit winners.
Carolina is on the track right now.
I'm Carolina. I'm from Argentina. I have a daughter, Avril. She born last year. And I have a dog. I don't know how to drive. I don't have license. I'm working at booking.com. In my company, we use a lot of machine learning. I know the theory behind, but I never worked close to this. I arrive early because I want to be the winner.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, 27.53.
That would be good enough to move to second. Carolina is using model number 1.
For competitors who are just getting started with Deep Racer, they have the option to pick 3 pre-trained models.
Ready to go?
Yeah. Can I have for model 1?
Model number 1 is designed to keep the car along the center line. It values being right in the middle of the track over any other parameter.
I have no experience at all with machine learning, so I just went with number 2, control over speed.
Model number 2 is about reducing the amount of steering the car does. It penalizes oversteering, instead asking the car to try to drive as straight as possible, even if that means veering off the center line.
No one tried number 3 today.
I have the model number 3, and it's blazing fast.
Model number 3, speed. This one is built to prioritize the ability to stay on the track fast over any other parameter.
Go, 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 go! Oh, 23.85.
That's record.
Himmo just jumped to the top of the time charts with the fastest lap we've seen so far.
The Amazon solutions are quite easy. You just click and get them running.
You might just end up at the top of the charts at the end of the day.
I'm confident that someone else will break my record. Hope for the human race.
Competition starting to heat up. It's getting tighter at the top of the leaderboard. If you think you can go faster, show us.
As the day wore on, people's models became more sophisticated and we started seeing some experimentation.
Norbert, tell me who you work for.
I work for Brightcubes, a very small company in the Netherlands, and I'm their AWS consultant.
Hi guys, Norbert. This is my hobby room. This is my 3D printer that I built by myself. Building my own car. Here's where I live, train, run, walk, enjoy my life. Before the summit, I saw some YouTube movies about standard code that AWS already provided for the Deep Razor. Mm-hmm. And I thought that can be a little bit smarter. Okay. So I tuned a little bit of the code.
Wonderful.
And Norbert thought, I can build better code.
My code is only 30 lines big.
I didn't actually see the code. He's keeping that to himself, and I respect that. But he did show me the parameters. He built a reward system to say, I'm going to start penalizing you. He's taking 10% off the total if the two wheels gets off the track.
If all wheels on track, he gets a reward multiplied by one. And if he's almost off track, he gets a discount.
There's absolutely some carrots in the middle of the track. But you get too far off, and yeah, the stick comes out. And in his case, it's a pretty big stick.
Maybe we should tune the hyperparameters.
Learning rate.
Try only the speed.
Jesper and Casper.
Yes.
So twins.
No.
No, unrelated.
I'm Jesper. I'm from Amsterdam. I really like speed and trying to push it. From my mountain biking experience, I'm quite competitive. I was the Dutch national champion under 23 years old.
My partner is Casper. We work closely together on developing the model.
I'm Casper Meijer, and I'm a data scientist in the Netherlands. I'm not an aggressive driver, but yeah, I sometimes exceed the speed limits. I'm pretty competitive. I had a sail regatta with some colleagues, and we won the whole competition. I do a lot with machine learning. I never did something with reinforcement learning.
At the moment we're in the simulation. We just saw the track actually and just shown that the simulation is actually applicable to real life.
Some cars were very slow but stay very precise in the middle of the track.
So we decided to discard the position of the car on the track and just focus on the speed.
If the car is not aware of its position on the track relative to the center, it might be zigzagging back and forth, and that's going to bleed speed all night long.
How's it testing?
This version is not so good, actually.
Okay, all right.
But we have multiple versions because it's quite risky to just look at speed. It might happen that we accidentally just destroy the car by driving too fast in the walls.
Optimize for speed, see what happens.
As you talk about the car, it's important to separate the physical car from the virtual world. In the virtual world, there's all sorts of things the car is aware of. It's aware of its compass position and where it is in relation to the track. In the physical world, there is one input, and that is the camera. It has to be able to find the geometric pieces in that image and pass that into the model. Now, the model is being processed by an Intel Atom processor, which was chosen by the Deep Racer engineers as the perfect balance between processor speed and battery consumption.
Just over 2.5 hours of racing to go here today.
If you think about a race car, it doesn't always go in the center. You take the corners. So I'll try to replicate some of the logic that a drone uses to make its way to waypoints.
Bart's been focusing on waypoints. That's how you actually get the car to not be on the center line, but start to curve inside the track as you move through. This is the next level we're looking for.
How's your test times going on the virtual track?
Latest I ran was 16.8.
That's close.
I believe Bart has a shot if the models had enough time to train. We really won't know until it gets on the track.
Start. You can increase the throttle a bit.
Oh, it went out, sorry. Oops. No. No. It likes left.
Yeah.
It likes going to the left.
No.
Whoa. Really? Come on. Okay. I'm sorry, the time is up.
No.
This really was a case where the model did not have enough time to train.
I wanted more time to train it in the console.
It takes time to reach convergence. There's a certain element in machine learning that's a combination of exploration and exploitation. Think about training a dog. A dog is going to, for the first while, not really know what you're asking the dog to do, so she'll try jumping up and laying down and doing things to get the treat. That's an exploration phase. In Deep Racer, that's the car driving into the grass or going really fast in a straight line. It's trying to experiment to see what it is and then see, did I get rewards from it? Then it moves into an exploitation phase where it knows it's got a good path. That convergence from what happens if I do something to I really like doing this thing, that's convergence.
But that takes time.
Can't wait for the virtual one to start as well to compete there.
The Virtual League allows anybody from anywhere in the world to create, train, and race their own models virtually and submit their times to a global leaderboard. The top times there also win a trip to Las Vegas.
Our next developer on the track has developed a model of his own creation.
Go!
Ah! Ooh! No!
This car's taking a bit of a beating here.
In Deep Racer, we provide a basic model that'll work good, but if you really want to get the championship cup, you gotta not be afraid to try to break some things.
Watching it crashing is actually more fun than seeing it going straight.
I think we tried it again.
It's getting tighter at the top of the leaderboard. Still some time on the clock.
I'm just watching the podium, going down. Then when I reach the 20th position, I say, okay, I need to play again.
Carolina is back. This is her second time.
I will choose the third model, Velocity, because we need to speed up. I don't know how, but we need to speed up.
It's off to a really good start.
Carolina's going with a slightly more aggressive model.
Still on track.
One that values speed and cutting the corners more than just staying on the track.
One more corner to go. This could be a good time.
I ended the race without going outside.
15.09.
Hey!
And it was a really good time.
Carolina goes to the top of the charts. Big smiles all around. Well done.
Carolina right now is our leader. She's the full second faster than the second place time. I've seen people with pre-trained models get below 15 seconds, but it takes skill.
I'm on the podium again. In the first position. I want this trophy in my desk.
Under an hour to go at Amsterdam Speedway.
Norbert, how's the testing?
Of course, limited in time. The model took 60 minutes for it.
All right, that is staying right on the track. That's a competition run right there, and it's still trying to explore. If it plays as well on the track as it does in the virtual simulator, we could be looking at today's winner.
Let's go.
Good luck.
I think you should just increase the throttle and let it have a free run. Wow, your model is really good.
13.5! Especially Norbert with our fastest lap so far. Round of applause for him. Yes!
Bringing high-end technology to a play toy. It inspires me. You can have a lot of fun with it. And you get immediately results. And that was great to see your own code working in that model. And that is great of Amazon, that they're bringing complex things on an easy way. And I have a lot of fun today.
Typically on race day, the last 60 minutes are where we see the best times because our competitors will have been training their models throughout the day. And this is when they break them out and we get to see who's really ready to take the cup home.
Still 40 minutes to go in competition here.
Can't wait to see how this plays. I like the aggressive stance. I haven't seen anyone else be that aggressive.
And just reward when you go forward.
As long as I'm on the track and I'm moving forward, give me treats.
Yeah. Yes.
Hopefully you'll stay on the track.
We'll see how it plays out.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Our final contestant on the track now. Time running down.
I do have some experience with racing under high pressure when the stakes are high. So I'm just gonna put it full throttle and see what happens.
Hopefully it will stay on track.
gets off to a really good start. That looked like a fast lap. What was the time?
We were really nervous. We were standing next to the track and keep an eye on the scoring board.
13.03, right on cue, a new fastest lap. How about that? 13.03 seconds, the fastest time we've seen under the time set by Norbert a few moments ago. That bumps Carolina outside of the podium.
Then I was not able to join to play again.
That concludes the final run here at Amsterdam Speedway. Finishing in third, Robert Vandenbogaert, a 14.15 second lap. Robert, congratulations. Why don't you take your spot there in the third place stand? Well done. Our second place finisher here today with a lap time of 13.5 seconds. Please welcome Norbert Overbeek. Congratulations, Norbert. Well done. Now, you developed your own model as well. What did you know about machine learning before you showed up here and tried your hand at this Deep Racer thing?
To be honest, nothing.
Nothing?
I just learned it from YouTube movies and the AWS site. I'm happy about this. And I was happy that he finished first.
To finish first, first you must finish, the old racing adage. Well, congratulations. Why don't you take your spot up there on the podium? Well done. But there could only be one champion. Our champion, in addition to the excellent jacket, also the trophy, and the Deep Racer car, will also receive an expenses paid trip to reInvent 2019 in Las Vegas with a lap time of a blistering 13.03 seconds from Pond Data Lab. Please welcome Jesper Slik. Well done, Jesper. You turned in your time relatively late in the day. Were you in the workshop? Were you working on this before you showed up and took to the track?
From the workshop, we learned how to train, and then we just tried to train for as long as possible before we could set a time.
Well, well done today. Congratulations. We hope to see you in Las Vegas in December.
Definitely. Thank you.
With this experience, I want to try to use reinforcement learning inside my daily job.
Automated marketing, for example, just lots and lots of decisions that you can improve in businesses with algorithms such as this.
There they are, your podium finishers here today in Amsterdam.
Second place, I'm happy about it. It's going to be on my desk, I think, at the office for a week, and then it's going to my home.
First position, Amsterdam. AWS Summit Amsterdam was perfect. Maar we kijken natuurlijk heel erg naar uit om de rest van de wereld te laten zien wat wij Nederlanders kunnen.
Jasper and Casper, today's winners, will move on to compete at the AWS reInvent Champions Cup in Las Vegas. Our next stop on Deep Racer TV, Sydney, Australia. We invite you to participate by coming to any of our upcoming summits or participate in the virtual league. Go to deepracerleague.com.